The students have ownership of the material, and it clearly demonstrates their knowledge.
We ask our teachers, is the performance that we want from kids short-term memory, or do we want comprehensive understanding of big ideas? We use the term performance-based assessment to challenge our teachers to put the measuring stick against the student demonstration of application, the performance of analysis.
Did you remember to go from north first?
59 degrees and then 11 feet.
Is the performance that I could solve an algorithm that was handed to me on a piece of paper? Or is the performance that I can solve a real world problem that I have to determine the appropriate algorithms to use to begin with?
We wanted to come up with a performance-based assessment.
So we sat down at a table and just started saying, these are the things that we wanted to assess. Law of sines, the law of cosines, right triangle trigonometry, bearings.
We had a discussion about where can I integrate something relevant in this unit I'm doing on polar coordinates.
Like the kind of you would see on radar blips, you know, directing a plane or a ship.
And we came up with the idea of mission relief, which not only uses polar coordinates, but reviews a lot of the trig concepts that they're using throughout the year.
There are teams of three or four students. Some of them are air traffic controllers. Some are pilots.
The project has physically two settings. There is a group of air traffic controllers housed in one of the classrooms.
You're gonna go 66 degrees for 65 feet and 3 inches.
They provide coordinates to their co-pilots in the gym via FaceTime.
We used a map of the US that was to scale of the gymnasium and told our co-pilots the angle measures that they were to use and the distances they were to go to find the next mission.
43 feet,
7 inches.
The missions are some kind of disaster.
I think it's that one.
An earthquake or a flood. Someone needs to get to them to rescue them. When they scan the code, that will take them to a wiki space that has the disaster described and what they need to do in order to rescue the people.
A hurricane hit oil rig situated on a platform off a 1,500-yard-long sandy beach on the shore of Louisiana. From which end of the beach should the worker leave? Okay, so I labeled 1,500 as B, so then that's the side opposite the rig. That's angle, side, angle.
I think that's the law of sines.
I think you're right, because we have two angles.
Throughout the course, they keep a list of formulas that are useful in solving the trig problem, so they have to decide what formula to use to successfully complete their particular mission.
Each team has to solve 4 missions in order to score perfectly on the exam. Every member in the team gets the same grade, so they are dependent on each other.
38 feet, 3 inches.
For example, it's a sine equation, so it says y equals sine x, and the vertical change is the number in front of the sine.
Okay, so it'd be 10 cosine of 250x.
It helped pull together different concepts that we had worked on all year and use them in a real life application.
It's making a function.
We're looking for the accuracy of how they use the trigonometry to solve the mission. The co-pilots have to turn in all of their calculations. They can't just give an answer. Air traffic controllers will submit all of their work also. Mission 6 was the forest fire in Oregon.
They did this correctly. Most people, I think their error is in not taking the bearing from north-south line.
All right, I'm done with all my calculations. If you guys need help.
We observe how well they are communicating with each other. We will not help them solve the problems. We're guiding them.
Think about how you calculate amplitude.
So it would be like 0 10 minus 0 over 2, so it's actually 5.
4.5 inches. Even though we had some difficulties, it was a learning experience that I wouldn't take back.
One of the students we talked to who's in the calculus class this year, he said it was his favorite final, and we said, yes, but what did you retain from it? And he could tell us the exact problems, and he could tell us the math that he used.